Thank you.
You're welcome.
Mr. Toastmaster, fellow Toastmasters, and most welcome guests. How many of you have been in some type of competition in your life? Spelling bee, track, going for the lottery, anything like that is a competition. Now, some people say competition has a negative effect. It makes us more aggressive and less sensitive to the people that we're competing with. Well, I just read a book by Johann Huizinga called The Waning of the Middle Ages. He's a Dutch philosopher, sociologist, and he said that competition was really the first form of play. When you're little and you have a sibling and you kind of test to see who's the strongest or who can run the fastest, that competition is really play. It's innate in all human beings, and that play is how we learn and grow and actually evolve. So tonight, fellow Toastmasters, I'm going to explain to you the play of Table Topics, of our Table Topics contest and International Speech Contest. We have two contests every year in Toastmasters. Why do we do it? Because it seems like that would be a lot of work to put on a contest twice a year. But it is my contention that we do it because it's fun, because it's play. So this is our upcoming contest. This is the speech contest in green. We can have up to five contestants. We need to have three contestants. But if we only had two contestants, one would get first place and one would get second place. In table topics, again, ideally at least three contestants, but we can do up to five. Now, in the club, there's lines that are drawn. So there's two teams. There's the contestant team. We give speeches. We compete in a table topic to win. And then we have the support team, the officials, the people who put together the contest as contest master, chief judge, timers, counters, sergeant at arms, to help everything move smoothly and so we have fun. And we bring people in from outside of the club as well. We have other Toastmasters from other clubs who will come and help support our contest. We invite family members and guests. And we invite our guests to come back. Our contest will be on March 8th in the same time slot, 7 to 8:30. And in that hour and a half, we have a lot to accomplish. So what we do is we make it fun. There's jobs. Everybody has jobs. Now, because our theme is persuade with examples, I have a great example of how this works. One of our members joined a year ago, November, I believe. So when we came to the International Speech and Table Topic Competition in February, they hadn't completed six speeches yet. And that's, you have to have completed six speeches to compete in the speech contest, because this contest goes all the way up to world champion every year. So we want you to have a little foundation. But in table topics, if you are a paid member of Toastmasters and you haven't even given your icebreaker yet, you can compete in the table topics. Now, the member I'm speaking of specifically competed in table topics last year and did a great job. And then in our summer contest, which is the humorous speech and evaluation contest, that same member competed again and won the humorous speech contest of all the members of the club. And he hadn't even been in our club a year. I'm speaking of our current president, Christophe Perrault. Now, it's interesting, but I just went to a training for officers that missed the first training. And one of the things that they said at that training is something I believe in my whole heart. Success is 90% showing up. You know, it doesn't really matter if you win or lose. What matters is you give it a shot. And so what I want to do is identify of our members who would like to be in our international speech contest. And I know I spoke to our president, John Christoph, this afternoon, and he said he's going to be in the speech contest. So we have contestant one, John Christoph. Who else would like to compete in our international speech competition? Now, you have to have given six speeches. So you've given six speeches, Linda. You've given six speeches, Ralph. I think you've given six speeches, Michelle. I know you've given six speeches, Diane. And I thought that Diana, his struggle, would be here tonight, too. But it's 3 weeks till the contest, March 8th. Would you be willing to compete?
I have some questions. The speech that we're going to first have our speech here, and then the person who wins here will go to the next level.
Yes. That's usually about 3 or 4 weeks later.
Regardless of the answer.
We will go and cheer you on. We will go and be your team. We will support you.
Shucks, I can see some conflicts coming up in my schedule, so I don't think I'm going to make it.
All right. Ralph, how do you feel about international speech and table topics competition?
Normally I would say I would like to participate, but I have some things on my plate would prevent me from coming up with a really dynamic speech, so I probably will not be participating.
Enough said. Michelle?
Depends on the time.
All right.
I'm interested.
Very good. Diane?
I have to pass. I just started a job and it's a lot of training, so it's kind of overwhelming right now.
Okay, well, here's the news. I can't be a competitor and an official because that's a conflict of interest. So the only thing that can happen here is I pick which side I want to be on.
Diana might want to be in there.
I think so too. So we're going to put Diana as a potential. And, you know, Entisar is qualified and Raymond's coming back. So we'll say maybe. We got a maybe there. Do I have Michelle up there? I do. All right. So Linda and Ralph might end up on our official side. And I'm on the official side because I've already stuck my foot in it and I'm judging at another contest. So you can't be on both sides. Now, what about table topics? Table topics can be anyone. Besa.
Oh, man, no.
Will you compete in our table topics?
Yes.
Oh, God.
You're so good, Besa.
So much fun.
Thomas.
I'm good.
I do think you're good.
Oh, my.
Give it a shot. The worst thing that can happen is you lose, and then you're going to have to go on to the next level, and you learn something.
I may do that intentionally.
We hope you wouldn't. We're not gonna make
you
do it.
Try, Roxie, but I don't know.
Yay! All right. Now, of those who opted out of the international speech, do we got any table topics takers over here? Well, Linda, thank you because you're so good of a speaker. You've blown me away. I wish I'd been here the day you did that faith talk. That was good. Christian.
Sure.
Table topics. All right. Josh.
Only if you need a warm buddy.
Hey, you rocked this speech tonight. I know you'll do great. And Thomas, I'm counting on you. You in for table topics?
No, not this time.
All right. So then, I need a timer. A good timer. Would you be a timer for my contest? Yay. Timer one, Thomas. Now, we're not sure, but I think I'm going to make Betty the contest master, and I'll probably end up chief judge. This is like raising a child. It takes a village to raise a child, and it takes the whole club to put on a contest. But I want you to know that contests are fun, that through the contest, we grow and learn. And it is a special meeting. We bring food, we have a lot of fun. And so I'll be sending information to everyone over the next couple of weeks and talking about it more. But we've got our lineup. That's the inside scoop.
What is the speeches on?
Mr. Toastmaster, my time is running out.